Well, ladies, I finally found the perfect accessory for the little black dress. Hello! Isn't that nice? Thank you. Thank you. It's my souvenir from Labor Day weekend. And the worst part about that is I was totally sober. Yeah. That's pretty pathetic. I'm not going to bore you with the details because even my gyno says it's a lame story. Let's just say I'm the world's worst pool player. You gotta be pretty bad, right? Oh my god. Well, so since it happened on Labor Day, I had to go to the urgent care. It was the only thing open. Now, let me share some cautionary tales with you about the Ocean Medical Center in Redondo Beach on PCH and Avenue C. Okay, so hopefully, write it down. Ocean Medical, don't go there. They take me in and I have to have x-rays. The x-ray technician thinks he's Eminem. White guy, and back in his office, he's blaring rap music. Okay. So he's positioning my ankle to take the x-rays. And I'm going to repeat what he said to me verbatim. I could not make this up. He said, "Taking x-rays is like having sex. If the position ain't right, it ain't no good for nobody." Okay, thanks, Vanilla Ice. He didn't stop there either. I mean, that wasn't awkward enough. He comes back and he positions me for the next x-ray picture and he's like, "Girl, x-ray technicians, we do all our best work in the dark and we got all the right positions for penetration."
God.
Oh no! I am sincerely hoping that penetration is actually an x-ray term, not just an x-rated term. I don't know, this place is a total joke. So then they determine nothing's broken, it's just a serious sprain, level 2, whatever that means. They take me into the next room and this girl makes up a cast for me. Now I'm laying on my stomach so I can't really see what's going on, but she says, "Oh shit."
That's always good.
Yeah, Greek people you don't want to hear the words "oh shit" from. Your hairdresser, your pilot, and your medical professional. Thanks. Needless to say, I had to cut the cast off in the middle of the night because my little baby pinky toe was overlapping and I woke up in no circulation. Yeah. Ocean Medical. Do not go there.
Ocean Medical.
Yeah. Cross that off your list. And then I had to go and get crutches. Anybody know where they keep the crutches at CVS? That's right, in the back of the store, as far away as you can get from the door. Yeah, she's got it. That was my plan. The guy comes up to me, the clerk, and he's like, "Would you like me to have somebody bring those up to the front for you?"
No, I'll get it.
I was like, "Well, I was planning to crawl." Yeah, why not? Oh my god. And the good news, though, is I'm actually getting some use out of my exercise ball. I'm using it to sit on in the shower.
Awesome.
Finally, the thing had so much dust on it. Thank God it's at least clean now. But I'm also trying to squeeze in some crunches while I'm at it. So I lean back for the shampoo. And then I lean back for the conditioner. And then I lean back for my beer. I learned that one from my boyfriend. He can't take a single shower without a beer. Or three. Yes. I got him some shower organizers, the ones with the suction cups. He uses them as cup holders. Real classy. Well, here's a fun fact. Years ago, I actually used to date the owner of Pedone's, Mike. That's right, he used to hit this shit.
That is fun.
Yeah, when he saw me today, he told me to break a leg. I think he was serious. Oh my god. Yeah, I met Mike pretty soon after I moved to Hermosa Beach. years ago. I moved down here because I just had a bad breakup with my boyfriend, and I was on the rebound faster than Kobe Bryant. I should have known it wasn't going to work out with that guy because I'm a Sagittarius, he's an asshole. Yeah, but oh my god, when I came down here to Hermosa, I thought it was like a candy store full of men. Oh my god, sweet ones, spicy ones, dark chocolate, Mike. I was going out every night, meeting all kinds of guys. I wanted to collect them all, like action figures. Accessories sold separately, of course. This one guy, he was like a Ken doll. He was chiseled, hairless, invisible penis. Might as well have been invisible. I never got to see it. I'm not talking about Mike. So anyway, this guy, he asked me out on a date. I'm so excited. He's going to take me surfing. So I go out and I get a wetsuit, make sure it makes my ass look good. This is when I can stand. And I shave everywhere. Yeah, I was looking forward to it. And I got waterproof mascara, so it's gonna look good. I think I just lost some of the guys there. Mascara, it's what makes Pamela Anderson look like a whore. I mean, besides her boobs, the black stuff on her eyes. Okay, you know. So yeah, I was looking good and I was ready for my sexy wet surfing date. We paddle out, we catch some waves. Nothing's happening, nothing's happening. By the time we paddle back in and get out of the water, we're both checking out the same lifeguard. Yeah, my Ken doll wasn't looking for a Barbie. He was looking for a G.I. Joe. Yeah. I met another interesting gentleman on the beach one day. I was out walking, and this guy comes up to me, and he's like, "Hey, cupcake, you look tasty. I want to lick you up and down." I was in love. Actually, I was appalled. I mean, I love cupcakes. I do. But licking them up and down? That's out of line. So I looked this guy in the eye and I said, death. I don't think he... Thank you. I don't think he believed me, though.
I'm going to do that.
Maybe because I was wearing headphones. I don't know. Screw him. Screw him. No. One thing I love is commercials. Any other commercial lovers here? Ah, okay. Okay. We're easy targets for the advertising agency. My boyfriends and I... My boyfriends. One. One at a time. We actually use the DVR, the TiVo thing, to rewind. Oh my god, you gotta check out this commercial. Look at this one. We love it. There's a commercial on right now for the new Gillette razor. They say that their razor helps reduce tug and pull. I am totally confused, because most of the guys I know like to tug and pull. I don't know. But look, does it work? I don't know. We have to find out. I don't know. Teach their own.
Boyfriends.
Oh, you have to ask one of my boyfriends to try it. They are all too busy tugging and pulling. So. The one commercial, one type of commercial that I don't like, and I'm sure you're all with me on this, is the political commercials. Yeah. You know, the ones that end, "I'm a jackass, and I approve this message." Yeah. All right. What I want to know is, where are the commercials for this, I don't know what they're calling it, Proposition 420? You know, the movement to legalize pot in California? Prop 19. Prop 19. Oh my gosh, we got some legal beagles here. Where's my potheads at? I got one back there. Ex-pothead, okay. And the rest of you are all too stoned to raise your hand. I get it. I get it. Here's what I think is probably going on with that campaign. I think the guys are probably sitting around and they're like, "Don't worry about it. You're just paranoid." Dude. Where's the cookies? You know, the joke would actually be funnier if I could do a better impersonation of a high person. The sad truth is I'm allergic to smoke. And the one time that I did try to smoke pot, it was with my friends here, and we were sitting in front of the fireplace, and I laughed so hard at something so stupid that I fell back.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes! It was a very special birthday of my friend Leah. So I fell back, and then eventually I'm like, dude, what's that smell? Something's burning. Oh, shit, it's me. And I still have a nice scar there to prove it. Like, oh, my dad laughed at that one. Oh, my little daughter smoked pot that one time. Thanks, Dad. Glad you're cool about it. But I learned from that experience that I am not cut out for drugs. I am clumsy and confused and hungry enough on my own. Thank you. One thing I am happy about is wedding season is just about over. Thank God. Yeah. And amen. Right. Oh my God. Some of my friends actually like weddings. I think they're an expensive waste of time.
Very.
Now, I did get invited to one cool wedding. It was a midget wedding.
I would go to that.
You go to that one. Yeah. Yeah. It was fun. There was this midget family at our church when I went to church. And it was so cute. I mean, the little couple, they were like the same size as the little dolls on top of the cake. It was a short cake, of course. And the best part was the reception, because it was half midgets and half normal people. And they were dancing together. And, you know, the normal people would be leaning down to hold the midgets' hands. The midgets would be leaning up on their tippy toes to hold the normal people's hands, dancing cheek to crotch. Yeah. I had to dance with my legs crossed, because I made the mistake of wearing a short skirt, and I was dancing with the midget hairdresser. Yeah. So that was the midget girl in the family. Now, the midget son, he didn't have it so lucky. He actually ended up in juvie. I don't know what happened. I think maybe he snapped after they made him play the baby Jesus in the Christmas pageant for the 14th year in a row. You know? But, I mean, just imagine. I mean, it's got to be hard enough to be a midget. Imagine being a midget in jail.
Like a volleyball.
Like a volleyball, yeah. Right. Walking around in your little orange suit, looking like an Oompa Loompa. And you know, they say when you're in jail, you shouldn't bend down to pick up the soap in the shower. You would be the soap. Some guy would probably be using your head to scrub his balls. It's awful. I'll leave you guys with just another tidbit about my boyfriend, my main boyfriend. The one that I live with. Because he's such a genius. He got so excited when he found out I was getting a new wireless bra. He thought he was going to be able to call my boobs.
Gay boyfriend.
This one's actually straight. He's just stupid. Yeah, and you know, I thought that's actually a decent idea. A wearable, hands-free device. You know, depending on who's wearing it, it could be hands-free or hands-on. Yeah. So let's take a look at what that would look like. That would be something like this.
Yes, bro.
There we go. Bzzz. Ooh, I think I'm getting a call on my new wireless bra. Hello? Hi, Mom. Yes, I told you I'm okay. It was my bra. It drunk dialed you. Yes, I will do that. Hey, Mom, I gotta go. I'm getting a call on the other booth.
Exactly.
Line.
That's great. That's great.
Hello? Hello? Great, no bars. Can you hear me now? Thank you guys so much. I'm Christina Thomas. Thank you.